through responsible investment, you know, we tell the street that over the past 5 years, we've completed 620 projects with sustainability attributes. They're expected to save us, you know, roughly $20 million a year on utility savings and generate roughly 15 to 20% in returns.
I'm here today with Michael Chang, Vice President of Energy and Sustainability at Host Hotels and Resorts, and also Nareit's Leader in the Light Leadership Personified Award winner for 2023. At REITworld this year, you received the Leader in the Light Leadership Personified Award. Congratulations. What element of your ESG strategy do you expect to be most focused on in 2024?
First of all, thank you. I'm truly honored to receive this award, and it really wouldn't have been possible without the support of our senior leadership and their commitment to ESG, support from the top down, from the board to our C-suite, as well as our core CR team that provides the day-to-day support. So we're really excited. Last year we launched our long-term aspirational vision to become a net positive company, not only beyond net zero in carbon emissions, but across all environmental and social impacts in our business, including our value chain. So this framework really, you know, sets our long-term narrative on how we will approach ESG issues into the future. This year, we launched our 2030 goals. This is our fourth generation of ESG goals, and as well as an interim step, you know, towards that net positive future. In these goals, we have new targets around resilience. We have new targets around our suppliers, as well as enhanced social targets. So in 24, we'll be focused on, you know, implementing on those initiatives and make progress against those goals. This includes, you know, building on our climate risk program, as well as executing on our sustainable finance strategies of increasing green building certification to 40% in our portfolio, as well as increasing the use of renewable energy by 50% of our electricity consumption by 2030. So we're really excited to work on all of these things. And on top of all that, we're going to be focused on improving our data governance. You know, this is really in preparation for regulatory pressures to make sure that we have the confidence and the level of oversight that we need over our public disclosure.
And how do you think the REIT industry overall can move the needle on ESG going forward?
Well, something that I think we're doing a pretty good job at, and I think we will continue to do, is using our scale to engage on policy and methodology development, especially as ESG demands become more ambitious. So recent examples include engaging the White House on zero emissions buildings. It includes engaging the SEC on their climate-related disclosure rule. We've also been engaging on voluntary disclosure setting bodies, such as CREM and their climate risk tool, as well as a science-based target initiative who recently published their guidance specific to real estate. So, you know, these opportunities for engagement not only help develop policies that are aligned with our business, they also provide an opportunity for us to show leadership and set an example using our scale to you know, drive that impact across our industry and really communicate, you know, what we're doing in this space.
And how does Host Hotels' approach towards sustainability align with the company's broader corporate strategy?
So I would say that our ESG, our sustainability strategy, is a core component of our broader corporate strategy. Through responsible investment, you know, we tell the street that over the past 5 years, we've completed 620 projects with sustainability attributes. They're expected to save us, you know, roughly $20 million a year on utility savings and generate roughly 15 to 20% in returns. You know, we're not only able to show value creation at the asset level, these programs also enable us to access lower cost of capital through our sustainable financing. We have roughly $4 billion in green bonds and through our sustainability-linked credit facility that supports a lot of our efforts around energy efficiency, renewable energy, green building certification, things like that. So all of these activities are detailed out in our public disclosures, in our 10-K proxy statement, investor presentation, our annual CR report. So I would recommend folks that are interested to take a look. These resources are available on our corporate website and really tell our approach on how we use sustainability to drive value creation.